Do you want to learn how to make this beautiful, beautiful and glittery clock? If yes, then let's get started. And it's time to give a new look to this plain MDF base. And yes, it's in wall clock base, and which has two pieces, the dial and the plain base with a hole for your mechanism. So I have decided to use this beautiful mandala stencil, and I am going to use this, and for that I'm going to use this Montmartre modeling paste. And with my palette knife, I am going to spread this very nicely on my base. Now I am going to keep this half, so when you actually see your dial, you are going to have a bigger visibility of this. So I'm going to mark this. So I need to make sure that I have this hole. And now I'm going to spread my modeling paste very evenly. This is actually going to be the highlight of my project. As in the center, the dial is going to come, and I don't want to add any extra stuff there so that I can have my mechanism there. So that's the reason I'm going to do work only on the sides. And yes, it's a very, very, very big clock base, so don't worry, you will have so much of space to work. This is looking fab, and now I'm going to repeat this process on all the sides. You just need to make sure that you do not overlap your stencils, and by mistake you don't smudge your design, because that's really, really important. I'm going to speed up the drying process of my project. Now once my texture paste has dried out, I am going to use this sprinkle mist, the white shade, and I'm going to cover it up on my complete areas. This is just to cover my base. And I'm going to keep rotating my base so that the color spreads, and I am also going to use my paintbrush to spread this spray. I don't want my base to have the perfect white look, cause I am going to make some rustic detailing on this. So I'm just looking for covering the some areas of my project. Now I'm going to add some more spray here. So with the help of brush, I am just spreading it a little more. This is absolutely up to you that what kind of white color you want on your base, and then accordingly you can spread it. But please do make sure that you do not rub your paint brushes on your modeling paste, although it has dried out, but then still you don't want to take a chance of ruining it. So please make sure that you are really smooth and easy with your paint brushes on your texture paste. Now I am just going to add some more textures on the white, my detailing and my design, and again I'm going to give it a nice brush up. So this is super easy and super fun. Just make sure you don't have any extra texture or color on your hole, cause later on we have to fix up our mechanism here. And now I'm going to use my heat gun to dry this up. Now my texture paste has dried out and my white color has also dried out. It's time to add some new color to it. So here I'm going to use my sprinkle mist, and before that I'm going to spray a plain water on my edges so that I can evenly spread my color. So what I'm going to do is I am going to have my plain water spray on the complete edge. You just need to make sure that you cover it completely with water so that you get a very tinge of shade and you also have your nice background color. And now I am going to mix the shade and just spray it. Once I'm done with my spray, I just need to roll it up so that my color spreads out really well. If you want, you can add some more water, and I want a little lighter shade, so definitely I need to spread my colors more well. And again, I'm going to repeat the process of rotating my board. Now if you want, you can evenly just spread it with your paint brushes. This is going to be just a very lighter version of spraying. And now again I'm going to let it dry completely, but before that I think I need to add some more shade. I just need to highlight this a bit more. and now you can see you have such a nice and beautiful color on your board. Now you can see you have such nice white and blue color background, and now again I let it dry completely. So now my base has dried out and it's time to add some decorative stuff to this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep it a little simple but yes very glittery, and I am going to have my glitters on this. Yes, it's the same indigo color glitter, which is a bit rough, which gives a really nice texture. So what I'm going to do is I am going to stick this on my MDF base. Now for that, what I'm going to do is I am going to spread my liquid adhesive, and I'm going to make sure that I spread it really well, and I am going to do it portion by portion so that my adhesive does not dry out and I get ample amount to stick my glitter. I just need to make sure that I don't overdo with my adhesive, because definitely we don't want too much of adhesive on the edges. So I am going to be a little quick here, because like I said, I don't want my adhesive to dry and I don't want to have excessive adhesive. So too many things to be taken care of, and I'm going to have this now. What I'm going to do is I am going to sprinkle my glitter on this much portion. I'll take out the extra. Now I will move on to the next area, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do it part by part so that I cover up the complete area really well, and again I'm going to spread it with my fingers. You can even use your paintbrush, but with my liquid adhesive I really feel comfortable with my fingers, and just dab it, and you can have your pressures as you require for your project. And once I'm done with this, again I'm going to sprinkle my glitter here. So my table is really clean. I just made sure that I clean my table really well before starting this step, and now I'm going to collect my glitter. Collect these on a glitter on a paper, and I'm going to start sprinkling this on the remaining areas. The dial size is really big, so that's the reason I can't even have a big size paper here. So maybe I need to adjust my light, and now you can see how beautiful this looks. I'm going to repeat the same. First I need to remove the excessive glitter, and now I'm going to repeat the same process on the other side also. I am going to have a twist at the end of this glitter, so please do stay tuned, because it's not just the plain sticking of glitter. We are going to add a touch of drama to this. And a mixed media project is incomplete without any such drama and some twist. So, yes. I'm just dabbing, and you just need to make sure that your base is really covered well with your adhesive, because that is something which is going to hold your glitter really well. Now with a paintbrush again, I'm going to collect my glitter, and as you can see, these are so shiny, and yes, it is going to add a good extra charm to my project. So here I am. So here I'm going to sprinkle this again. Now again I need to collect some glitter. This is a little messy thing, but a project, especially a mixed media project, is really incomplete without any mess. So yes, now I am done with sprinkling of my glitter on this area also. Now this is just looking fab. Now first I will collect all the glitter on this piece of paper. The last portion remaining, and as you can see on the complete project, I have used my indigo blue, but for the last one I'm going to use my white color. This is just to add a little contrast to my project. Now again I am going to have my liquid adhesive. I'm going to make sure that I apply a generous amount of my liquid adhesive, and then I'm going to spread it well again. So I'll start from one corner. I'll start dabbing this. Just dab. This is really fun. You can even have your tacky tape for the bigger, broader edges. Even that also works wonderfully. But I love using my liquid adhesive for sticking my glitters, because it gives you some time to play around, so that in case if I want to remove that, I can do that with the liquid adhesive, which is not possible with the tacky tape. So, but of course, if you have decided that this is how it is going to be, or you want it to be, then surely you can go ahead with that. And now I am just going to do these lines, and I'm done. So now I'll start spreading this white color glitter. Don't worry about it. It looks that you're using too much of glitter, but once you collect the remaining, the glitter which is there on the table, you will realize, oh, you actually used so little glitter on your project. So that's the beauty of using glitters on your project, that you really need very less amount. And now this is just looking so beautiful with a twist. Now let me collect all the glitters from the down, and then I'll be back. Okay, so now my both the bases are ready. They have dried out completely, and now it's time to stick them. So here I'm going to use my glue drop, and I'm going to stick these on my base, but on the back side. And I will do that for all the four corners. Just make sure you don't press that, so that it does not stick to your prod. I'm going to have one more here and now I'm going to keep it on the base and press it well. And now the final thing is to add your amazing dials to it. So here I have this beautiful wild color dialer and I'm going to have this on my project. This is how I am going to screw this and my mixed media clock is ready.